I'll discuss a very useful problem on rotational motion, conservation of angular momentum, impulse, collision, translational motion. Everything is there in this problem. I will rate it as a very good problem, and I've taken it from Pathfinder. The situation which is given to us is two disks of equal masses. Mass is m each, and they are identical. Their radius is r. Both are having radius r. So let me write to begin with, moment of inertia is mr square upon 2 of both the disk. They are placed on a table which is frictionless, ideal situation. So means there is no torque on their axis because of the table, because of the friction. Now one of the disk is rotating with angular velocity omega 0 at t is equal to 0. So it would have maintained it omega 0 had we not disturbed it, because there is no friction. So we ideal situation, it keeps on rotating with omega 0. At certain point of time, we push the other disk with a velocity u without any rotational motion, and it comes in the straight line, and there is a head-on collision. Means the velocity u is along the line joining the two centers of the disk. The collision is inelastic, means there is no velocity of separation. Coefficient of restitution is taken as zero. And it is said that when the collision stops or when the collision ceases, when the two disks separate, something is happening. Lot of many things are happening when the collision is taking place. I'll explain that. There is no friction between the disks. Now here, don't confuse that the rotational velocity of the two disks will be same. That would have been same. There is a caution. Please treat these problems separately. If their axes are fixed, if there is no motion of their axis or no relative motion of their axis, only then when you say they are not slipping, you can say their omega means their common velocity is same. They will have certain common velocity, which is the point of contact, and their omega will be same only when their radius is same. Here, even if their radius is same, even if in this situation when the radius is same, if they are not slipping, when they are separating, it doesn't mean their omega is same. Don't take omega as same when the axis is free. Common point velocity is same, but it may make omega same, it may not make omega same. That depends what is happening to the two axes. So that is point to be noted. When it is not a fixed axis, just don't think that if they are not slipping and their radius is common, their omega will be common. Not omega will be same, not necessarily. It depends on the position of the axis, how the axes are behaving. I will be discussing a lot of key points in this problem. Idea is to basically expose the concept so that you can tackle different problems. If not this straight problem, which this straight problem doesn't come, problem comes in different shape and color, but this problem has many shades of whip gear, so you will capture most of the colors to solve other problems. Now coming back to the problem, let me draw the diagram. Diagram drawing is very crucial in such problems, and this is the diagram which I presume is happening during the time t when the collision is taking place. Means they are interacting for a short time t. Now when they are interacting, there is force F acting here. It was rotating with some velocity omega 0, which will change of course to omega dash, and it will also gain some velocity because of the friction which will happen. Finally the slipping ceases, friction ceases, means they are not slipping. Now right now collision is happening, they are slipping against each other. I am taking an intermediate position somewhere within the time t it is happening. It is having omega dash as the velocity. This is the interacting force. Now this disk is rotating in this direction, so the resistance will be against the rotation, means because of the friction between the two, mu f will be in this direction on this disk, and this is just at the tangent. I have drawn slightly offset so that it doesn't look equal, means it doesn't cross each other. I've just slightly off shown differently so that this is for this disk and this is for this disk. Actually they are acting just at the point of contact. So this is mu f. This is the force in this direction. These are the forces which are acting. Mind you, these are not the external forces. Now when I take, I'll be doing two things. I'll draw right part of the equation, taking whole thing as a system, and I'll also write the equation taking two disks as system separately, because to solve the problem I have to have both the approaches here. When I take both the disks as a common system, there is no external force. When I take one disk as a common system, then these becomes the external force. For this disk, mu f and f are the external forces. This disk also, this and this are the external forces, but for the whole system there is no external force. Now during the collision these things are happening, it is attaining some angular velocity, and since this velocity of separation is zero, coefficient of restitution is zero in this direction. Apply coefficient of restitution always at the contact point, draw a tangent at the contact point, draw a normal along this line. You have to apply the coefficient of restitution, don't apply in any direction. Now it had initial velocity u in horizontal direction, and let u1 be the velocity after the collision. It had zero velocity in this direction, and let u2 be the final velocity after the when the collision is just breaking. I'll come to rotationals later on. Let me first take the motion along x-axis. There will be motion along y-axis, and there will be rotations also. Three type of motions will happen because of this collision. Now since the coefficient of restitution is zero, e is zero, velocity of separation of these two have to be zero. It doesn't mean that they stick to each other. Here they don't stick to each other. Only thing is that their velocity by which they are separating is zero. So u2 is equal to u1, but they don't move together. This contact force has also given them tangential forces, so it will acquire velocity v in this direction. It will acquire velocity v in this direction, because these forces are, so you take all the forces as if they are acting on the center of mass as far as your translational motion is concerned. So for the translational motion along x-axis, I have already taken these are the forces which were acting, and since the coefficient of restitution is zero, both will move with the same velocity, u2 is equal to u1. What is that? I'll just find out. Because of the tangential forces, both have to move in this direction, because the center of mass will acquire the velocity in the direction of the force. Direction of forces along y-axis, one in this direction, one in this direction, and you draw the forces, you assume as if the forces are acting on the center of mass. We do everything with respect to center of mass in case of translational motion. Now since now I take it as a system, when you take it as a system, the initial along x-axis, the initial momentum is u along x-axis. The initial momentum is u, because this was not moving, only this was moving, mass is m, and the final momentum is mu1 plus mu1. Both are moving with the same velocity, u2 is u1, and both are moving in the same direction. Only then you don't have velocity of e as zero, but it doesn't mean that they stick together. They don't stick together. You can see one start moving like this, so one acquires velocity like this, another acquires velocity, absolute velocity like this. They have both horizontal component which are equal, and they will have vertical components which are equal. That is how the motion starts happening, along with the rotational motion to which I will come, which is more complex to analyze. So from here I get u1 is equal to u upon 2. This is very simple part. I could have also analyzed using force, using the impulse, and I will do by that also, because you should understand the idea is not to solve the problem, idea is to discuss the conceptual aspects of torque, impulse, momentum, all these things when collisions are happening. So what is the impulse applied on this body is Ft. Always write in terms of the direction. Ft is acting in this direction, which is equal to this impulse is equal to change in momentum in this direction. So what is the final momentum in this direction of this body is m u. U2 is equal to u1, or I write mu1. Suppose I have not found this. Without this, I am deriving by different method. You will get u1 is equal to u upon 2. I have shown you one method by taking one system. I am doing by other method because that may be relevant in some problem. I just want to discuss it. So Ft is equal to mu1, final momentum of this body along the direction of force, and initial was 0. So this is how I write one equation. Another equation I write for this body. On this body, the force is acting in this direction. So I write Ft, but all your reference point will be direction of force. For this body, force was along x. Here the force is along minus x. So I have to write momentum in terms of this reference, minus x reference. So what is the final momentum in this direction? This body, I said, is moving with u1 in that direction. So final momentum is minus mu1, because my reference is this direction. This is the reference point. And what is the initial momentum? Minus initial momentum in this direction is how much? Body was traveling by mu in that direction initially. When I write in this direction, it is minus mu. So it gives me minus mu1 plus mu is equal to Ft. Since Ft is same, so I get mu1 is equal to minus mu1 plus mu. So u1 is equal to u upon 2. You got the same result, but this method should also be known. That is why I covered it. Now it is one aspect of the problem which was very, very easy part, that is the velocity in x direction is u upon 2. Now what will be the velocity in y direction? Can I write both v as same? I have written as same. Why I have written as same is because when I take it as a system, there is no momentum along y-axis. Initially, there was no component of velocity along y-axis. So momentum along y-axis has to remain conserved. So final momentum of both the body has to be equal and opposite to have it zero again. Since both the masses are same, I have written velocity as same. So these two velocities are equal in opposite direction. Now what is this value of v? We have found the horizontal component, but we have to find now the vertical components and also the rotational velocity. Now it is said that when they are just separating, the slippage ceases. Let the common point have the velocity u. Now what is the velocity of this common point when this common point is on this disk? Actually at the point of contact, but I am saying when it is on this disk, when it is on this disk, it has to have the same velocity, the contact point. Now when I take this disk as the basis for finding velocity of this common point, I have to write in terms of the resultant velocities of this center of mass is moving. Now my velocity is, this common velocity is along negative y, along this direction. So center of mass was moving in along opposite to this direction. I have taken u as this direction. So center of mass is opposite to it, so minus v. And velocity of this point with respect to center of mass is omega dash r in this direction. So I write plus omega dash r. So this is how it has to be written. The relative velocity with respect to center of mass is omega dash r is in this direction, but v was in that direction, so this is minus, this is plus, and both has to give you this result. Another I write for this body. The velocity is along this direction, so I write plus v. And omega dash r is being added to v plus omega dash r. These two are equal, so I get v plus omega dash r is equal to minus v plus omega dash r. So twice v is equal to, one is omega double dash, sorry, this is omega double dash, one was this is omega double dash, as I mentioned initially. So twice v is equal to omega dash minus omega double dash into r. Just check whether it is correct. I write v plus omega double dash r is equal to minus v plus omega dash r. So twice v is equal to omega dash minus omega double dash. Yes, that's correct. So one equation I have got, which is this. This is an important relationship which I'll be using. Now another relationship I will get when I take this as a point about which I conserve the angular momentum. Because this, at this point, though you have frictional forces, but their moment about this point is zero because they are acting at this point itself. So let me conserve the angular momentum about this point. The angular momentum about this point of initially only this disk was rotating, its momentum was I omega. Let me write here, I omega is the initial momentum. No other momentum is there, it had no velocity. Only the momentum which is there about the center of mass will be the momentum about this point. Though it is outside the center of mass, but center of mass is not moving. So I write only this. And please note, as far as this point is concerned, this is my reference. All this which is anticlockwise, I'll take as positive. So initial is I omega. What is when the collision is just complete? When the collision is just complete, it is moving with omega dash. So it is I omega dash. But it is also moving with certain velocity, which gives it moment of momentum about this point, which is mv times this perpendicular distance r. And it is also anticlockwise about this point. Moment of momentum is also anticlockwise, same direction. So I add m omega dash into r. mv into r is the moment of momentum. Mv times r, and it is plus. What about this final momentum of this disk about this point? It is rotating in clockwise, please note. So in reference to this, I have to write minus I omega dash, omega double dash. It is minus, but it is moving in this direction. So moment of momentum is same as anticlockwise. So plus mvr. Its velocity is v, distance is r. So moment of momentum of both are getting added. So I get, I is how much? Mv, mr square upon 2. Let me write that. Lot of calculation in this problem. Mr, there is one more important equation which I will write. Mr square upon 2 omega is equal to mr square upon 2 omega dash minus mr square upon 2 omega double dash plus twice mvr. Let me divide by mr square. So I get omega upon 2 is equal to omega dash upon 2 minus omega double dash upon 2 plus twice v upon r. This is one relationship which I have got. Now these two relations I can use, omega dash minus omega double dash into r. You multiply this by r to make it more simple, and multiply it by 2 also. So you get omega r is equal to r omega dash minus omega double dash plus 4v. Now omega dash minus omega double dash r is twice v, so omega r is equal to twice v plus 4v is equal to 6v. So my velocity is omega r upon 6. So one point is done. So my vertical velocity is omega r upon 6. I have to find only now omega is remaining. So what? But when you write the answer, what is the absolute velocity? This is u upon 2, and this one for that body, it is omega r upon 6. These two are perpendicular, so resultant is omega r upon 6 ka whole square plus u upon 2 ka whole square, and you get v r is equal to under root u square upon 4 plus omega square r square upon 36. So v r is equal to, take 1 upon 4 out, you get 1 upon 2 u square plus, it is 49, so it becomes omega r upon 3 whole square. So this is one part of the answer, which is the velocity. Now I have to find one more point, which is the angular velocity. I leave it to you to do that, but I will tell only because like lecture becomes very lengthy. Anyway, you also don't watch every step. You need only ideas. So the idea is how to get that part now. Now apply